Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Hello friends, I welcome you all to this video. We are with Morphological Image Processing chapter number 10 for digital image processing. So morphological fundamental operations we started: dilation, erosion, extensions with the opening and closing, the various properties we have also addressed with the help of certain MATLAB programs also. The applications like the extraction of the boundary, extraction of the connected components we have addressed. Also the region filling, convex hull we have seen. So now let us address the another thing that is possible with the help of morphological image processing operations, that it is thinning. So let us have it. So here for thinning procedure used by the help of morphological image processing, we take input represented by set A along with a structuring element, the usual notation by capital B. So here the A input and the structuring element B will be having a symbol of thinning, a circle having a cross sign inside it. So this can be defined with the help of the hit or miss transformation we have already understood. So here the representation of A thinned by B is equal to capital A minus the hit or miss transformation representation between the inputs set A and the structuring element B. Or in another fashion, we can also obtain the same thinning operation by having the intersection of the input set A with that of the complement of the result of hit or miss transformation represented. Now here, for this particular topic, we are interested only in the pattern matching with the help of the structuring element. So basically, the hit or miss transformation is for the purpose of template matching, and especially we have all these morphological operations for the binary images. So here, there is no concern of the background operation that is required in the hit or miss transformation. Now a more useful expression for the purpose of the thinning, capital A symmetrically based on the sequence of the structuring elements can be represented here. So capital B, a set of B to the power 1, B to the power 2, B to the power 3, up to in general B to the power N we can have. So the B to the power I is a rotated version of the B to the power I minus 1. So here, using the concept, we now define the thinning procedure by the sequence of the structuring elements, as we have A thinned by the set B that has been represented earlier. So here the A is first of all thinned by the B to the power 1, the structuring element. This result is then thinned by B to the power 2. The intermediate result is then further thinned by B to the power 3. This process goes on up to the use of last structuring element represented B to the power N. Now, this is the process to thin A by one pass with B1 as we discussed. Then the result with the B to the power 2 and so on until the A is thinned with the one pass of B to the power N here. The entire process is to be repeated here until there are no further changes to occur into the result there. Now we can be having the example discussed with the help of one figure. So part A of the figure will show you the set of the structuring elements commonly used for the thinning purpose. So here we start with the structuring element B to the power 1. Like this, we have the total 8 structuring elements. The origin of the structuring element we have represented here at the middle of the 3x3 dimension here. So the origin is the same. Rest of the portion that has been either shaded or the don't care conditions marked with the cross sign are getting rotated as we switch from B to the power 1 to B to the power 2 up to B to the power 8, the structuring elements here. Now we have the representation with the help of figure B. So figure part B shows a set capital A that is to be thinned by using the procedure. So this is the one input, and the previous figure was the another input, the structuring elements here. The origin for the input figure represented by the set A is the first row, first column element pixel here. So most of the pixels have been shaded in this particular set A, and only the 10 pixels have been represented by the complete white. Now we have a figure C next to the figure B that shows the result of the thinning with the first structuring element represented b to the power 1. So this is the intermediate result. We obtain the symbolic representation A thinned by b to the power 1 is represented here. So here in this particular figure C, you can notice that the number of white pixels have been increased. So this increase of number of white pixels is into the first row, you can notice from the second pixel. Next to this, we have figures D up to the figures K, which I'll be discussing, that will show you the results of the application of the thinning with the help of the structuring elements B to the power 2 up to B to the power 8. So this is the figure D that shows A thinned by B to the power 2 here. Next to that, we have A thinned by B to the power 3. The next one, A thinned by B to the power 4 here. We continue, A thinned by B to the power 5, A thinned by B to the power 6, A thinned by B to the power 7, and B to the power 8 also, there is no more changes is to occur there. Now here we have A thinned by B to the power 1, 2, 3. A thinned by B to the power 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3 here. So we have got this much of structure into the resultant binary image. Now here we have achieved the conversion after the second pass of B to the power 4. As we have seen, the figure K that shows the thin result. Finally, we represent figure L showing the thinned set of converted M connectivity eliminate multiple paths here. So this is the figure L. Now let us address the thinning example here by applying the thinning process to the input image using the structuring element that can be shown like this. So in this example, we have the input image, the binary image. So we have the selected white pixels represented here. And now this is the corresponding structuring element that we can be using here that has the origin at the middle here. The rest of the two don't care conditions are there in the structuring element. So we start with the step-by-step approach for the thinning process. In the step one, we perform the eroded operation of the input image with the help of the given structuring element. Very first of all, we find the eroded input image with the help of the corresponding structuring element, and then the resultant image can be visualized like this. So this is the erosion operation by the symbol having a circle, and inside it is there it is a minus sign here. So you can see here by the erosion, that is a local minima operation, the corresponding binary image has changed a lot here. Next to the step number one, we go for step number two, where we shall be performing the erosion of the complement of the input and the complement of the structuring element. So the resultant image can be visualized as, so here both the complements for the inputs and the structuring element we have taken, the corresponding eroded image, the local minima again will be obtained, and it is represented on to the right hand side. So now we continue up to the step number three to find the hit or miss transformation of the input image. It is the algorithm for the template matching of the binary types here. The hit or miss transformation is the intersection of the two results that just now we have seen here. So this resultant image is subtracted from the original input image and we get the thinned original image. So this can be illustrated into the next figure here. So here we find the difference here, the subtraction we carry out, and the result we have onto the right hand side. So changing the structuring element will yield a different extent of the thinning operation. Here we can comment. So I hope this is enough to address the thinning operation with the help of the morphological domain of image processing. So it was very straightforward for thinning operation. By the next lecture, we shall be addressing another kind of morphological image processing operation, that it is thickening obtained. So for the knowledge of digital image processing, we share our videos. For more information and the knowledge, you can subscribe to this Ekeeda channel. Thank you.